250-pound defenseman sees it played right back along by his defense partner, Scuderi. Swatted back out, and a two-on-one developing. Moving in is Talbot up the wing. A shot! He scores! Max Talbot with two goals in the game, and it's 2-0.
Oh, that's old Brad Stewart again. Max Talbot's in his head. Well, what a defensive play, as you mentioned, Pierre. In his own zone. Stop it right here. The pinch by Brad Stewart and then support forces the two-on-one. Kunitz wins the battle. Hoodler comes over now a two-on-one. And then the quick shot over the glove of Chris Osgood. Maxime Talbot looks, gets to the top of the circle, and what I love is he keeps that puck in a shooting position.
Off the glass, out of the zone. 3:40 to go. LaPierre against Green. Green missed it. Moore shoots. He scores! Dominic Moore gives Montreal a 2-0 lead with 3:36 to go.
This play starts by the veteran defenseman Hal Gill, a so-called one-dimensional type of guy, making just the simple play in his own zone. Right here, off the glass and out, and go at it. That's what he's telling his speedier forwards. LaPierre takes one man Green away. In comes Dominic Moore, beats the goaltender Varlamov with a quick shot under the right arm. Oh my.
And it comes loose for McDonough. Ryan McDonough across. Here comes a chance to first goals. It is the rookie. First goal of the game, and none bigger than that for Colton. You've got all the bodies on the side, and Corey Perry gets involved. That's his D-man on the other side, and instead he gets to the outside. What a play coming down from the right side. McDonough knows that he's got the outlet in Savard, and Savard tape to tape. Go to the net, get your stick on the ice. Good things happen, and for Ross Colton, couldn't be a bigger one than that. His first Stanley Cup final goal. Gives the Tampa Bay Lightning and the crowd that was getting a little anxious an opportunity to get on their feet.
Now hits against Bozak for the draw. Bozak won a maroon. Plays it off. Thomas going to the net. Off the post. Scores! Patrick Maroon and the Blues win it in game 7. Double overtime.
It's a scramble draw from Bozak, and then Thomas does the rest. He maneuvers himself through some traffic, through the faceoff dot, and then pulls it inside and lays it at the net. It goes off the post, off the back of Bishop, and then Maroon jams it into the net. And there you go.
Puck behind the net. Back out to Oleksiak. Now Sekera with it for Dallas. The return for Oleksiak. Jamie Oleksiak leaving it for Sekera. Kivi Ranta setting up in front. He shoots, he scores! A hat trick and a game 7 overtime winner for Joel Kivi Ranta of the Dallas Stars, who move on to the Western Conference Final.
Here you see, they were engaged. You'll see quickly coming down low, Andre Sekera. He's going to find Kivi Ranta, pulled away from coverage, and he just snaps it home. But Kivi Ranta inserted because of no Andrew Cogliano, gets the hat trick, the OT winner, and the series winner, AJ, to move Dallas into the Western Conference Final.
Well, two things that strike me about this goal, the unselfishness of the Dallas Stars. They got a change during this. They kept pressure on in the offensive zone. Tired Colorado Avalanche out there. They get other people. And then Kivi Ranta is around the crease. We can hear the ref saying, watch the crease, watch the crease. That's how close he was. And instead, then he backs out. And he makes that space. He finds that hole. And he gets that quick shot off. And he gives this elation to the Dallas Stars bench and to his goaltender, Anton Khudobin.
I don't think enough been made about what Hudobin did this whole series, and for Jim Neal and the management team, relief. Total and unbelievable relief. And for Nathan MacKinnon, sudden death.
Pass picked off at center ice by Erik Karlsson. In he comes, throws it ahead, good right along, scores! The overtime winner, and the Sharks have come back to win the game and the series.
He's going to get outside of Braden McNabb, cut hard to the net, and beat Marc-Andre Fleury around the right foot. What a nice feed from Karlsson, but it's the bold move by Goodrow to get this around Fleury and send the Sharks into the second.
Kennedy, return to Malkin. Now Orpik with a drive, he scores! Brooks Orpik sends the Pittsburgh Penguins to a second round meeting with the Ottawa Senators at the 7:49 mark of overtime.
Come the live legs, good pinch down by Malkin. Insulated by Kennedy, give it back to Kennedy, out to the point, Brooks Orpik shoots the puck, up and over. Great give and go, Malkin, Kennedy, get it back to the point. Don't pass up a shot on goal. I don't know if it touches Kennedy or not. Orpik shoots it, and it just goes off the bar and in.
Brooks Orpik did not score a goal during the regular season. He has never scored a playoff goal prior to tonight in 77 games. He had not scored a goal of any kind, Pierre, in 106 games. His last goal came against the Islanders in November of 2011.
We'll move it. Sobolka for St. Louis. Given a shove by Hansel, he stays with it. Sobolka out in front. The pass, Pierre scores! Magnus Pierre! The St. Louis Blues win in overtime.
Game with the Blues stick with it. A turnover by Devin Dubnyk along the wall, and look at the play by Vladimir Sobolka. Protect the puck, get that puck to an area where he can find Pajarvi. This is all Sobolka right here, as he's able to find a seam, drive it, finds Pajarvi.
Free, meanwhile it's played along to him. Centering pass flagged down by Green, played into traffic though. Starting back up with it now is Martinez in a 3-on-2. Clifford gave it across. It's held in a shot. Safe. Rebound. Score! Stanley Cup! Martinez!
Scored the OT winner in Game 7 in the Western Conference Finals against the Chicago Blackhawks. And he does it again to win the Stanley Cup. The fourth line does it for the LA Kings. Kyle Clifford, who had an outstanding game from the first period, Doc, you picked up on that. And Tyler Toffoli had one shift in the third period. And then Daryl Sutter gave him the opportunity. He gets the puck to the net, the big rebound, and the reaction from Martinez.
Boston Bruins now turn it over. A 2-on-1. Knubel coming with Ward. Knubel with a chance. Backhander loose. They score! They score! They score! It's over! Ward on the rebound. Good morning, good afternoon, and good night, Boston. The King is dead. There will be a new Stanley Cup champion. The Capitals are still dancing. A rebound off Thomas, and the Capitals have won it.
Kachisov for the Devils plays it cross ice into the far corner. Matteau swoops in to intercept. Matteau behind the net, swings it in front. He scores! Matteau! 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 Defend Matteau! And the Rangers have one more hill to climb, baby! But it's Moose Vancouver! The Rangers are headed to the final!
Hennigan can't clear it. Oilers keep it in, little backhander, stop, rebound, and that's stopped by Ward. Oilers come close on a rebound again, but Cam Ward made that important stop.
And Ward makes two big saves, keep his team down by just one.
It's flipped to the line, a long shot, oh, and it came close, rebound, oh, stopped by Ward. A fantastic save by Cam Ward to keep it tied. got it in deep. Ward is out of the net. Pushed a little bit. The crowd won't like that. Ward falls, and the crowd doesn't like that. And Hemsky has the puck. It'll be back near the line where Pronger had to come in. Hemsky center. Smith center. Oh, what a save! I don't believe that one. I do not believe the goalie stopped that. And he did. That's the best I've seen in quite some time.
Horkoff was wrong.
Puck is dropped cleanly. Shot in there. Hemsky, oh, what a great move. Look out. He's coming in. It's right on. And the rebound is grabbed behind the net. Hemsky got it in front. Hemsky again. Shot. Stop. Shot. Missed shot. Oh, my goodness. 3.8 seconds remaining. And Cam Ward does it again. Unbelievable. I can't believe my eyes. Look at this.
And they get the line. Fired in front by Williams. That's broken up. And a two-on-one Edmonton again. Samsonov coming down with Dvorak. And a third up. Samsonov for it. Oh, what a play. And Ward down to hang on to that.
A three-on-one rush that was nicely executed by the Oilers. And what a stop on this pass across.
So a miraculous save by Cam Ward. And Edmonton finally gets out of his own. They get it up over the line and coming in on the outside. The shot, rebound! How did Ward get that? How did he stop that? How did he stop it? He did.